ZF has a very broad portfolio, which I think really enables us to advance mobility across multiple aspects. Part of our strategy is what we would call our 4x3. So we have four main action areas. Those would be integrated safety, vehicle motion control, electromobility, and automated driving. And those four action fields we're using to drive mobility in three different industries. So in the passenger car industry, in the commercial vehicle industry, and then also in the industrial or off-road industry, which would include, you know, tractors, it could include marine, rail, anything that's off-road. And then within those areas, especially if we focus on the automated driving and advanced driver assist systems, we really focus on see, think, and act. So the entire system to be able to consider what actions to take and then take those actions. So on the see side, we have the complete sensor portfolio that is needed in order to figure out what is going on in the environment. So that would be comprised of cameras, radars, LiDARs, as well as other sensor devices. Then on the think side, that's really the processing or the compute power. And so we have a range of safety domain ECUs that will be able to take the data coming from the sensors, analyze that data, and define then what to do with that. And then on the ACT side, that's the actual actuation, so braking and steering, as well as dampers and other chassis components that then enable us to control the vehicle's movement, both in terms of longitudinal control, lateral control, and even vertical control as we think about, you know, potholes and roads and ups and downs.
If you look at our technologies today, camera, radar, LiDAR, it's used in the space, in the ADAS space today, for automatic emergency braking, lane keeping, things of that nature. We're already starting to see benefits from that technology to lessen the number of accidents, especially like rear end accidents and low speed accidents are already being addressed by some of this technology. And we look at it from a safety basic standpoint. So you take this technology, you start with the standard basics of safety, and then you grow that toward automated driving. So even, I would say, lower levels of automated driving where we might automatically stop a vehicle or we might automatically keep a vehicle in its lane, it's not a full automated driving system that you can driverlessly go to another location, but that technology is the foundation for future automated driving capability. We're investing a lot of money into the AD space. So I think over the next 5 years or 5 or 7 years, there's $14 billion invested in automated driving. And the neat thing about ZF is that we're not just one dimensional. So we have the sensing electronics, we have the central computing or the thinking that does all the calculation, the artificial intelligence to help cars behave more like you and I, hopefully even better. We have the chassis systems for vehicle motion control to make sure that the ride is smooth, it doesn't incur injury or incur sickness. And so we have a lot of different aspects in various areas of automotive that's really going to, I would say, drive the market.
There are still several barriers to full automated driving in the industry. If we go back to what the SAE levels are, from level 1 through level 3, a driver must be available to come back into the loop, versus level 4, level 5, a driver doesn't need to be in the loop at all. So really the tricky point is level 3, where you have to say the driver must be available to come back into the loop. And so one of the things that we as ZF think about is, what does that human-machine interaction look like? We need to be able to know that the driver is available to come back into the loop, then we need to be able to confirm that the driver is back in the loop. And so a couple of things that we have in our portfolio to help us drive that. One would be some of the haptic alerts that we can use through a seatbelt. So a seatbelt will always be in contact with the human. You can use that as a haptic alert to alert the driver to the fact that you need to put your hands back on the wheel, your eyes back on the road. Another element that's in our portfolio is our interior observation sensor. So essentially cameras that are inside the vehicle, looking at both the driver as well as the occupants to see what position they're in, make sure they have their eyes on the road, make sure they have their hands on the wheel. And so we have actually two different variants of interior observation sensors. One would be a 2D, two-dimensional system that can be used more in the fully automated driving situation to see how many people are within the vehicle, to be able to see, for example, in a fully automated vehicle, if something got left behind in a vehicle. Or then the 3D, which can really assess where are the driver's hands, to check where his eyes are they on the road, or are they not on the road?
For the most part, we look at our AD mobility, we include the electrification and the automated driving kind of into one. We see the need for the electrification more so for the environmental aspects, and then we see the AD in terms of being able to get more and more people in different places. We add value to society by being able to move people around that maybe can't move themselves around any longer, be it vision impaired, be it elderly, or whatever the case may be. And then if we can get fewer cars on the road, more ride sharing, we can make I would say mobility more efficient, then we're doing our part.
You know, we have an incredibly exciting portfolio. We are disrupting the industry. We are changing the way people's lives will be in the future. You know, I often wonder, even with my own children, if they will ever drive, you know, because that's how different the world might look when they grow up.